I think at this point in time there is some differences in terms of the approach. SAFA has just recently introduced a technical master plan. I know that with the new leadership, congratulations to them once again, there is a vision that they are putting together. It is then up to the various structures, because there is no way you are going to sit as SASFA, produce a kind of a player that does not talk to the national agenda. These players, by the way, when they are not at school, they belong to the LFAs. But as you know that in LFAs, not LFAs have clubs, but all areas have schools. And where there are schools, there are learners. And where there are learners, there's football. And that is why our role is to assist the LFAs in those regions to develop and get more clubs. Because not all of them are having that. So we will have to work together. Let's give the new leadership the opportunity to put their programs together, because it is going to be give and take to say what do we bring to the table, because by and large most of the administrators at school level are equally teachers, are at the same people. Some of them are president. More than 20 of those regions are headed by teachers who are also at the same time responsible for schools football. So they will have to be working together. And I'm glad we have ample time to prepare for 2018 World Cup in Russia. We're still having a challenge of some schools who do not want to participate for a variety of reasons. Some of the former Model C schools, for selfish reasons, I must say, they have facilities, beautiful facilities, and they don't see a reason why they should go and play in the dusty streets in the townships. We still need to change that mindset. But we have others who would say, this is a rugby school, this is a cricket school, we're having a full-time rugby coach, we don't have a full-time coach, and therefore we don't want to go and embarrass ourselves.
Make sure that they attend the compulsory life skills sessions, and those include sections on financial education, which is very important obviously for them, because we hear all these horror stories about footballers who, you know, have reached their peak and they have nothing, you know, by the time they've hit 35-40 they've got nothing left. So it's very important for us to make sure that the boys are educated in that way. Then we also have a health section that looks at HIV and AIDS and other lifestyle diseases, where again it's important for them to understand that they need to look after themselves. And then lastly we have a section on building their personal brands, so it teaches them how to conduct themselves, how to interact with the media, and really to help grow them into young men that are upstanding good citizens that we as a country can be proud of.